Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Diva Pandey and in today's video I am going to talk about a very common problem in almost all the beginners. So if you are a beginner and you think that I can't use logic in programming, what should I do, then this video is going to be very helpful for you. So if you are a new developer and recently stepped into programming, you might be getting frustrated when you see that you don't get logics in programming and you don't know how to start solving a specific problem. You see, other developers are good at using their brains in programming and solving the coding questions very quickly. It also happens that when someone else is explaining the same problem and its solution, you understand something, but when you try to solve the question on your own, you got stuck there. It is a common problem in beginners and they give up on programming because they think programming is not the cup of my tea. You can't deny that logic is the fundamental key to become a good programmer. It doesn't matter if you are a front-end developer or back-end developer, you really need to use logic in order to solve a problem or optimize your code. Now the question is, why you don't get the logic in programming? And how to get better at programming logic? The problem that most of the beginners are failed to understand is until or unless, I'm repeating again, until or unless your brain wouldn't do a lot of practice, it is impossible to get the logic in programming. Take an example of a typist or footballer. The reason why a typist is good at typing or footballer is good in his game is because of practice. When you practice enough for something, the response time is reduced for your brain and you eventually get the logics or solution for the problem. Practicing enough for the beginners in programming makes you experienced, and more experience you will have, the better programmer you will become. Also, you need to be patient enough not to leave it by thinking it is not a cup of tea. Understand that there is no shortcut to get better at programming, but there are some techniques and tips to get better at logic in programming. So I'm going to discuss some techniques, but remember that all the techniques require practice, and definitely patience. So now let's talk about the techniques that are going to help you. The first one is solve new problems every day. The first advice is, once you solve a specific problem, don't repeat it for more than 3 or 4 times. 3 to 4 times is okay, but then move to the next problem and face new challenges. Let's say you are practicing for printing different kinds of patterns. Once you practice enough of 2 or 3 times, then move to the next coding challenge. Keep moving on and try to face a new problem every single day. Your brain has to prepare itself for the new challenge to reduce the response time and get the logic in programming. Solving a problem to print even and odd numbers multiple times for a couple of days wouldn't help you in programming. So learn new things every day. This will also give you exposure to real life problems and it will help you to write code for new challenging situations on problems. The second point is, keep moving on level by level. When you start doing programming, start with the easy problem from some resource and then move to the next level. Practice enough for a variety of questions at the easy level, then move to some complex programs, intermediate level questions, and then try to solve a variety of questions for this level. Again, move to the next level or more complex problems, hard level questions, and solve a lot of problems. A lot of websites are there, like Geeks for Geeks, Hacker Rank, Code Wars, Coding Game, to practice and improve the logics in programming level by level. And the third step is, divide problems in smaller chunks. This is the most important. When you are given a problem, firstly try to understand the complete program and find out what exactly needs to be done. Think about the problem carefully and write down on paper what steps you need to take in order to solve a specific problem. Think about all the case scenarios, steps, and according to that, write down the input or variables that you need to take in order to solve the problem. For example, you need to write a program to solve the addition of two numbers. That's a very basic problem. Now break down the problem into smaller chunks. What will be the first step? By reading it, you got to know that you need two numbers and both need to be stored somewhere in memory, right? So step two would be to add those numbers you need operand. Plus symbol operator. So step three is to store the addition result. You need some memory to store the result. Two variables you will need the variable. So step four will be you need to display the result to the user, or you need to use it somewhere else in the program. So writing smaller steps will help you to map complex problems into smaller manageable chunks. These smaller chunks can be solved individually and then it can be merged to get the final output or actual solution. The fourth step is check other people's code. One of the best things to get better at programming logic is keep checking the code that others have written. Check code written by other developers on Stack Overflow, which is the largest community for developers, GitHub, Bitbucket, or other open source libraries. And the final one is the make projects. One of the most important things that a beginner or experienced person should follow to get better at programming logic is to make projects. Working on some real life projects give you more exposure and experience to become better at programming. You can choose any kind of project to build, such as a web app, Android app, or iOS app. Make calculators, e-commerce projects, personal portfolio, or anything that you love to build. You can make any small application, or if you are experienced, you can build some complex or big projects. So now I will also give you some tips that don't skip the question while solving some exercises. Most of the beginners make a common mistake that they skip some questions and move to the next chapter. Suppose if there are 10 questions and you solved 7 questions, rest 3 questions you skip because you think it is easy. After that, you solve 4 questions on your own and you check the answers for 3 questions from somewhere else. Now when you move to the second chapter and start solving the exercise from this chapter, you face difficulty because your brain is not trained to handle the variety of questions for the second chapter. So don't skip the question, okay? And second is, when someone is you really need to get your hands dirty in code, means when someone is teaching programming, don't just understand the concept and think that you don't need to solve the problems on your own. If you understand everything whatever the next person is teaching you, you really need to get the hands dirty in code. You can't get better at building logics in programming until or unless you don't practice on your own. And the third one is, don't check the solution immediately. Check the solution when you spend enough amount of time and is still unable to solve the problem. Try to solve the problem on your own first and have patience. Once you solve it, check the solution written by others. So the fourth is, when you make the theoretical concept, the fourth tip is the theoretical concept builds the logic basic foundation and helps in solving the problem. When you make some program and you feel that you need to read some theoretical concept in order to solve the problem, then please go through the theoretical concept first. And fifth and last one is, be consistent. Don't leave a gap. It is really important to practice for the programming. Questions every day. Practicing for 3 days and leaving it for 2 days breaks the rhythm and doesn't help in getting better at programming, especially for beginners. So the final mantra is practice, practice, and practice. Thank you so much.